The queen may have raised the white flag, but she will not give up the throne. Hey, yo, Probst! Hello, welcome back everyone to the video series dedicated show on CBS that is a loose cannon, it does not play by the rules. That's right, we're talking about Survivor Season 40, Winners at War, Episode 7. Now there's a lot to cover from this episode, so we're just gonna jump into it at the edge of extinction, where both Parvati and Sandra make their way onto the edge of extinction after the double tribal council vote out last episode. And they tell their stories of how they were voted out. Everyone was surprised about how Sandra was voted out. And then the Edge of Extinction people tell them about their daily struggles of how to get rice, where they're sleeping. And after taking all that information in, Sandra said, "No thank you, peace out Girl Scout, I'm done." And she essentially announces her retirement from Survivor. I completely understand where she's coming from, her decision. And I just want to say I appreciate everything she's given to the game. And I hope we see her back on future Survivor seasons at like a counseling member, kind of like how she was in Island of Idols. I just liked her in that capacity a lot, and I think she liked it as well. But let's stay on the edge of extinction for the next day, where Ethan and Parvati, we get a view into their friendship as Ethan is telling Parvati about his daily struggles of what he goes through every single day here on the edge of extinction. And Parvati just gives him positivity, tells him to keep going. You're stronger than you think you are. Never give up. He says, "I won't." It's a very nice, touching moment. Later on, Ethan finds a box of scrolls, passes them out to everybody, and they all read them and says that there are 4 fire tokens scattered on the end of all these trails. Go find them. It's a scavenger hunt, and one Survivor player could get as many as they can. All 4 are up for grabs for whoever. So they all take off. They leave rice on the fire. They're running through this thing, and the way the edit is set up, it looks like Tyson's the only one that finds a fire token, and everybody else is just in the dark. They don't know where these things are. They can't find them in the trees, on the ground. However, it's a sneaky edit, as Boston Rob has found 3 of the 4 before anybody else. When you go back and rewatch it, he's actually putting something in his pockets as he's running up to where Tyson was. With that being the case, the scavenger hunt ends with Boston Rob at 3 and Tyson with 1. Now let's check in on the 3 tribes before going into the immunity challenge. And we're gonna start off with Sele, and they come back from tribal, and Yul is feeling a little weary about Wendell and what he said. They both appreciate each other's honesty. The next day, Wendell is talking to Michelle, and of course, Wendell is a little curt, a little passive aggressive, and that's where Yul and Michelle have a one-on-one conversation, and they both decide that maybe Wendell's the next person to vote out. So Wendell's on the outside of the Sele tribe at the moment. Now let's go over to the Decal tribe, where everybody's having a good old time. Now that Sandra's voted out, everybody's doing well. They're racing on the beach. Tony thinks that he is on the right side of the numbers. He thinks that he's very close with Kim and that he's getting closer with Jeremy. And he thinks that Denise showed her hand, as she is a strong player and a big old target, that if they were to go to Tribal Council, she would be the next one to be voted out. However, that's the exact opposite of how everyone else is feeling. In reality, Denise and Jeremy are like this. Jeremy wants to get Tony out next, and Kim actually wants to work with Denise and Jeremy over Tony, and actually wants to work with them going into the merge, as that is coming up very, very soon. And Denise and Kim also talk to each other about how they want to get closer together as they go throughout the game, and they want to actually sit next to each other at the final 3, at the final 2. So it's not looking good for Tony on that aspect of the Decal tribe. Now let's go over to Yara, where Adam is for sure on the outs of the Yara tribe, as he is getting frustrated with everybody on that tribe. He thinks that Sophie, Sarah, and Ben are really close with each other. He feels like Ben and Sarah have the hidden immunity idol, and he just thinks that anything Ben says is like nails on a chalkboard. I feel as though he is just a pouty Pete, and everybody can feel the tension. And if they were to go to Tribal Council, he would definitely be the next one to go. I just think he's so frustrated about how the game is going for him. But now let's go on to the immunity challenge, where this is the immunity challenge where everybody on the tribe has to carry this giant saucer, have to take it through obstacles to get through a water source, fill it up with water as much as you can, try not to spill the water as you go back through the obstacle course, fill up the well. If you fill it up enough, you drop down some puzzle pieces. You have to then take your saucer and puzzle pieces and make a puzzle inside the saucer. The first two tribes to finish this wins immunity, and the last place has to go to tribal council. When Jeff says go, that's when everybody takes off and DeKal gets a early lead. They get their saucer, they get water, they're going through these obstacles pretty quickly, which makes them lose a ton of water. Sele is second and they lose a ton of water. Yara decides to take the time to get their water and move through these obstacles very, very slowly. This is a risky procedure, as if they have to go back the next time around, they will be at a very big disadvantage, but they go very, very slow. The other tribes are able to dump their water, get back over to the water source, and start making their way back to the well just when Yara was hitting their well the first time around. But this risk pays off, as Yara was able to drop their puzzle pieces the first time around. They get their puzzle pieces, and that's when Sophie and Ben has a head start on the puzzle. And let me tell you right now, Sophie has become the puzzle queen in this game. She's shown that she is a strong puzzle master and that she will take over anybody in these puzzles, which makes her a very deep threat heading into the post-merge, which is happening very, very soon. DeKal was able to get their puzzle piece the second, and Sele was third. They're doing their puzzles. The people on the puzzles for Sele was Wendell and Michelle. Yara, like I said, is Sophie and Ben, and then DeKal is Jeremy and Denise. They're working on the puzzle pieces, and of course, Sophie and Ben get theirs done first. Yara gets the first safety and immunity from Tribal, and now the last place team is going to happen here. They're doing their puzzles. It's very, very close. It's neck and neck, and that's when Wendell kind of showboats off a little bit. We've seen this happen throughout this season, but he shows off again. They have like four puzzle pieces left, and he's yelling for Jeff to come check their puzzle, as Jeff is standing over by DeKal. It's not like you're not gonna finish your puzzle and then everybody's gonna yell for Jeff to come over and check it out. But he is standing over by DeKal, but I don't know the reasoning why he would yell for Jeff when they still have some more puzzle pieces on the board. But DeKal was able to put their puzzle pieces down. Sele loses by 1 second, and a lot of people are pissed off on the Sele, mainly Nick and Yule, thinking that if Wendell would just focus on the puzzle instead of yelling for Jeff prematurely, that possibly they could have been the ones saved. I mean, it was 1 second, it was super, super close. It could have went one way or the other, but the tribe that's going to Tribal Council was Sele. Last Tribal Council, it was the old Sele were on the bottom. It was Poverty or Michelle was going to be the one that was going to leave the game, and mainly it was going to be Poverty, and that's what happened. So coming into this episode, you're thinking if they're going to stay with the numbers, then Michelle's the one on the chopping block. But now the power has shifted to Michelle and Nick, as they are the ones that could make the power move, as now everything rests in their hands. Yule wants Wendell out. Wendell wants Yule out, and now it's essentially up to Nick and Michelle to vote out who they want to get out. And it looks as though they want to get Wendell out. However, when Michelle brings up the notion of fire tokens and wanting her fire tokens back from Wendell, but if she were to vote him out, that he wouldn't give them back to her, that's when Yule comes up with a plan to try to get the fire tokens away from Wendell. That just puts out an eerie vibe with Nick and Michelle, and they're thinking, wow, Yule is very, like, methodical. He comes up with a lot of plans. If we go further with them, we're not going to be the smartest ones on the island. It's always going to be Yule, one step ahead of everybody. So they think of everything in their mind heading to Tribal Council. At Tribal Council, that's when they're talking about fire tokens, they're talking about how the game is played, and how Yule is the last old school player left in the game. And that kind of foreshadowed how things were gonna happen, as everybody votes and they vote out Yule 3-1. The one vote for Wendell was Yule. Everybody else voted for Yule to leave. And that's when Yule had his torch snuffed out. He went down, he had two fire tokens. He gave one to Sarah, one to Sophie on the Yara tribe, and made his way to the edge of extinction. And it's a crummy thing, because I really, really liked Yule. I wanted to see him go far. And there's one thing I wanted to bring up, one talking point that came out at this Tribal Council, and that was Jeff bringing up the old school players and how maybe they aren't adapting to the game as it's evolved since the last time they played, and that they can't keep up with how the game is fast paced and quickly moving. I think that's a portion of what some of these old school players are dealing with, is not being able to keep up with the game. But I also think that it's just that these new school players have been watching these old schoolers, that they've watched those when they were wee little lads and wee little ladies, and they're just watching them as they're growing up, and these people that they idolize, they put them on a pedestal, and they think that they're the best things in the world, and so when they get to play with them, they are such bigger, their winnings hold more water to them that they want to get them out because they deem them a way bigger threat than some of these new schooler players that maybe they've seen very, very recently, like in the past year or three. So instead, they want to get out the Povertys, the Boston Robs, the Tonys, the Yules, because they played so long ago that they have these big pictures of them that they don't want to be caught in the crosshairs of these master planners and master manipulators. So they would rather get them out and then deal with the new schoolers because they see them more on a level field. But that's just my opinion. What did you think about this episode? Let me know that in the comment section below. What did you think about my explanation of the new schoolers looking at the old schoolers and all the old schoolers now at the edge of extinction? Let me know that in the comment section below. What did you think about this tribal? Were you sad to see Yule go? Were you sad to see Sandra leave at the beginning of this episode? Let me know that in the comment section below. But thank you so much for watching. Join me next week as I will be back for another Survivor review and recap. And also, I'm going to be coming out with a ton and ton more challenge content, especially leading into the premiere of the new season, Total Madness, on April 1st. But thank you so much for watching. And until then, peace.